like I was reading, I went through this phase where I was reading about, you know, the dark side of socialism. I want to know the subject that I want to know everything. And reading Gulag Archipelago. Did you ever read that one?
No.
Holy smokes. This is like one of those ones they should make you read in school, but they don't because it's a 2,000-page book, right?
Holy moly.
And it's all just about the Soviet communist era and how like 100 million people were killed basically by put through gulags. And it was a long enough period and that kids were born in the gulags. And here's the thing. They're just like, eh, this is just life. I mean, they're like little wild animals because the structure was just... You crush human structure and everything's in this horrible, you're basically born a villain. You don't even know why. So these kids were sort of very, very, you know, rough and violent, but they were happy. They were like little wild animals. And when you sort of see the progression of their lives, you're going, well, I hope they get a chance to live in a real society, but I'm not sure they're set for it anymore. But
right. But
they were living there. This is it. This is life. We're here. Let's do this. Let's be awesome, you know?
And they were making the best of it.
Yeah.
So what was the whole book is like that whole period and that whole country and during that political time, but was that a main focus of it or was that just like...
No, it was an exploration of here's how society can go off the rails.
Okay.
When you're trying to build a utopia and everyone has to be equalized.
Right.
He wasn't studying psychopathy at the time. He didn't know the words because the science hadn't really been invented or he didn't click to it. He was just a writer that happened to get put into one of these prison camps. And he was just writing about all the stories, the human stories. Like he would meet amazing people who were university professors or just day laborers. And they were all, you know, the cancel culture went so dark, you know, and that's what you were left with is like, you're going, oh, I want my neighbor's apartment. I'll just call, you know, I'll just say, make up some bullshit about him. And then boom, they're in the camps. Jesus. And it basically, the psychopaths thrive in those people who love cancel culture.
Wow.
You're kind of going, is something a little wrong with them? Yes, there's something wrong with them. They love to hurt people. And so you just sort of see this inside view of... This conversation went dark.
Well,
it was so important to learn this. Like you're going, oh, I see the patterns. I see what's going on. We can't treat each other this way. We've got to, you know, like we were talking a little bit about shame before. Shame is a vital component of the human psyche because it allows you to not be a selfish dick, right? But the abuse of it can be, you can leverage it in such a way that it gives power to the person doing the leveraging. And, what was my point? I lost it.
That's okay.
Anyways, that's basically Solzhenitsyn was just writing about all the people that he would meet. And he just met these wonderful people who had just been interred. And it was just this one 30, 40 year tragedy that thank God it ended, right? And had to end because psychopaths can't manage stuff. Like, there's this whole story like...
they're managing things now.
one of the big cities, Moscow, I think, had this... very, at the time, modern plumbing system, right? So the water and the sewage and everything was managed correctly. But, oh, this guy, this engineers were vilified because they had heirs, you see. They thought that they were better than everyone else. But they didn't. They were just doing our jobs. Other people were, like, projecting their lack of self-esteem on these smarter people. So they villainized them, kicked them out, gave the jobs to psychos who... within a year you've got shit coming out of your taps and no water. It's like the whole thing collapsed because you need smart engineers but
without egos or that aren't psycho.
Holy smokes. Yeah.
Oh my god.
Anyway, it was a really harrowing bit of learning, but that's the kind of thing I like to sort of jump into and learn as much as I can about, so you can come out of it, leave it at the door. You don't want to bring that into your home, right? Yeah. But then it allows you to navigate reality in a way that is beautiful. Right. And so when I see little kids, I was playing Lego with the boys last night. I'm just like, you know, one of the kids was like, he's going through this little thing where he's built a little differently than his brother. His brother's very technically minded. He understands stuff and and I connect with him on that level. The other one just wants to be loved. And he's just like, if you're going for a walk, he's a little smaller, his legs are shorter, he gets left behind. And he's like, you left me behind. And I ran and picked him up. So, no, I wasn't leaving. Yes, you left me behind. You know, I was like, I'd never leave you behind. Yes, you would. And then I was like, oh, it's hot out. I had actually been not paying attention. This little boy, he was getting heat stroked, right?
Oh, and so in his feelings.
And then he's just like, ouch, you know, and, yeah. And you're going, this progresses to other stages. You have to sort of really manage how they say kids are always listening, but they're listening to the stuff that you don't even know you're saying.
Mm-hmm.
So you just become hyper aware. And so I want to know about all the ways I can mess up so I don't.
Yes.
So you kind of catch that sort of thing, right?
It kind of reminds me of what's happening right now with Black Lives Matter and...